When I came home from the bank, he was still emptying out Trevor's room. And the bed was going to be arriving around 4 o'clock. So I did a bunch of dishes, and while I was doing dishes, I hear this noise, and it turns out my piano from the front room. He was moving from the front room into Trevor's old room. And he also cleaned it up a bit and swept it and took a lot of things of Trevor's out. And he also grabbed all my clothes and put them in the closet. And he grabbed my dresser and my items on my side of the bed from the bedroom. And he respectfully put them in the room. He even asked if I wanted the chair from the living room so I'd have at least a place to sleep. And I said, no, thank you. That's okay.
Like, these kids are the hell.
So I was processing feelings. I felt like I was pretty healthy. There was even a song I was dancing to and singing to. And it's the Katy Perry song, Part of Me. And then he grabbed a bunch of things from under the bed that had really been cluttering up. And, you know, I should have cleaned under the bed a long time ago. Well, I did like 2 years ago, but the stuff has been accumulating and shoved under the bed for a while. So he asked me respectfully to clean up the stuff that he pulled out from under the bed. I go in there and it's like really dirty. So while I'm doing that, my bed's arriving. So, did you order yourself a bed? Well, yes, I did. Well, it's here. He's angry still. He's still throwing things around. He's still huffing and puffing. Even though he's being respectful with how he's placing my stuff, and he's being respectful with how he addresses me, I can tell he's hurting. I can tell he's having a really hard time with all of this. And I didn't have to go through this. I wish I didn't have to put my foot down and say, no, I can't do this anymore. I wish I didn't need this. But this is where we're at emotionally. So I go in there and I take a few videos. Here, I'll show those videos right now. I'll edit this and I'll show you how the room looked once he was done with it. Alright, so that's what the room liked when he was done with it. That's what the room looked like when he was done with it. And then I'll show you a few more videos. They're all just quick videos. Let me show you. Alright, so that last video there, you saw all the work I had to do to move everything around so that I could fit the twin bed in there. And it barely fits. And I don't have any sheets for the bed. And I'm not sleeping on plastic and I'm not sleeping on a bare mattress, so I'm gonna go get some sheets. And it's really surreal. It's a very interesting moment now in history, and me and Jim's marriage, and me and Jim's life. April 11th, 2020. That's the day I moved out of the bedroom. And I'm in this separate room, and it's almost freeing. It almost feels surreal and awesome and everything, but I see him hurting. I see him in pain. I see the way to one side of the bedroom in what used to be our room. Now it's his room. And now he's going to go and buy himself a $100 desk. And I think it's stupid that he's doing it. That's my personal opinion. But I can't control him. I used to try, I guess. I used to try to control him, and he would try to control me. And I didn't like him being upset with me. So, of course, I would try to control the situation and do what I needed to do so that he wasn't upset. But now he's going to borrow my car and go pick up this $100 desk. And I guess he's going to put his computer and stuff in there. He already has his Xbox. He already has the TV. And he's probably going to seclude himself in that bedroom more so than me. That way I have the computer room. I have my bedroom. I have the front room with the kids. Like, we really are, like, separating right now. It's really interesting how this is turning out. And he's having a really hard time accepting it. And I don't blame him. He's a control freak. I'm a control freak. This is hard stuff. I always said that he'd make a worse ex-husband than he would a husband, because at least as a husband, I can sweet talk him and tell him what he wants to hear so that he plays nice, so that he's kinder, so that he's not such a bear. But right now he's a whiny, spoiled brat that's not getting his way, and I think he threw me out of the bedroom because he's in pain and he's trying to process and he's trying to let go of me, and he's also trying to, like, manipulate me in a way that makes me feel like, see, you wanted this, this is what you get, so I'm gonna throw you out just like this. I'm gonna put all your stuff in here. That's probably what he was thinking when he was doing it. But I, instead of looking at it that way, I chose to look at it as, wow, you really love me. Because I didn't have to clean out Trevor's stuff. I didn't have to clean up this room. I didn't have to bring my stuff in here. You must really love me that you're willing to let me live in this room instead of just kick me out entirely. I chose to look at it differently. So my demeanor right now, I'm doing my best not to fall apart. I'm trying to keep strong. I'm trying to stay balanced. And my demeanor right now is, I'm sad. I'm sad that we're going through stuff. I'm sad that we couldn't figure it out before this step. And like my daughter kept saying, her quote that she kept telling me was, sometimes it has to get worse before it gets better. And I keep remembering that. I'm just constantly repeating that in my head, is this is the last thing I haven't tried. I haven't tried standing up for myself, leaving the room, separating myself emotionally, physically, mentally. I can't keep doing what I've always done, because it's not working. He doesn't recognize how toxic he is with his demands and his requirements and his rules and his expectations. He doesn't recognize that it's an emotional abuse that he does. And I got my shit too. I'm not innocent in this. I have my shit that I do also. Anyways, I'm gonna go inside and go get my sheets at Walmart. I'll talk to you later. Bye.